Can you build an MCP server for the Federal Reserve in 60 seconds? Let's find out. For today's demonstration, we're going to build an MCP server to access the rich data sources at the Federal Reserve Economic Database, or FRED for short. This incredible API has access to hundreds of unique financial data points spanning the last few decades. Let's put 60 seconds on the clock and get started. I'll start by pulling down a TypeScript template built on Hono, a lightweight web framework that's perfect for building MCP servers. Next, I'll bring in my OpenAPI spec for FRED, which defines the REST API we'll be surfacing and will be exposing. Now, I'll use the free CNCF Wasm Claude WebAssembly Shell, or WASH, and its Sandbox MCP plugin to automatically generate a complete MCP server from that spec. And at this point, we're done. But let's start the dev loop with WASH dev. Now, WASH automatically detects the right idiomatic workflow for TypeScript. It kicks off npm run dev, and because it supports pre and post plugins, it also spins up an MCP inspector to visualize our server during the dev process. Now let's connect, inspect, and select a tool to test. Boom, we're finished. But there are dozens of MCP generators on the market that can help you to quickly build agentic workflows. Why should you care about this one for building your agentic AI? As AI workflows are being built around our core capabilities, the crown jewels of the enterprise, the most important thing, we need to recognize that the non-deterministic inputs and outputs of AI workflows lead to the agentic-specific risks like LLM prompt injection, data exfiltration, and lateral movement. The news is full of exploited, poorly implemented MCP servers, and you don't want to be one of them. The OWASP Top 10 for LLM and Generative AI details these risks and more, highlighting exploits like remote code execution, command injection, direct content exfiltration, credential leakage, network pivoting, trusted path exploitation, and more. Deploying your MCP server on a typical container enables many of those risks. Each MCP server is bundled with libraries, all full of POSIX, dependencies, and an entire Linux distribution. Even if it is 100% secure when we deploy it, the rich ecosystem of unnecessary capabilities and tools become a part of the cyber kill chain. But there's more. The excessive container capabilities mean that they suffer from the cold start problem. So they always need to be on, driving the high cost of idle infrastructure, devastating for those companies that care about reliability and are running multiple instances of each server. Deploying a full OS per server limits our platform density, unnecessarily growing our fleet's infrastructure costs. These dependencies are then tightly coupled with the local environment, reducing portability, and the large attack surface of containers then needs to be maintained, meaning many of the enterprises today are stuck with 5,000 teams, each fixing the same vulnerability one time. With Sandbox MCP, we deploy our MCP servers with capability-driven WebAssembly components, meaning the MCP server only has access to the minimal list of system calls that are necessary to execute. These deny by default. Capability-driven sandboxes significantly reduce the risk and types of exploitation available. The smaller size of a component means that we can start them instantly. It's not just that they are physically smaller, a few kilobytes or megabytes, there are far fewer things to initialize to be ready to run. When we have smaller components that can scale to zero with no cold starts, it means that we can achieve significantly more dense, efficient, and cost-performant platforms. Capabilities are pluggable and therefore more portable. And less code means less to maintain. This is magnified by the fact that we can do runtime composition with components. Imagine what you can accomplish when instead of having 5,000 teams each fix the same CVE one time, you can move to a world where one team can fix 5,000 apps at once. WebAssembly components are aligned to timeless security principles. Deny by default, least privilege, immutable and declarative infrastructure. They represent the next evolution in platform efficiency, continuing the industry's long tradition of shifting capabilities down into the platform. Shift down reduces the implementation, maintenance, and operational load that teams carry on a per-application basis. Just as containers abstracted the complexity away from virtual machines, components take it a step further, delivering lighter, faster, and more secure execution. Would you rather maintain an OS, libraries, dependencies, and business logic per application, or just the business logic? This is not a zero-sum choice. Organizations can flexibly combine components and containers to build faster, operate leaner, and deliver more value with less friction. And best of all, with Cosmonic Control, Sandbox MCP supports standard WebAssembly components integrated with your existing platforms like Backstage, Argo, GitHub Actions, and it supports Kubernetes out of the box on any cloud or edge, including your own. Let's deploy our Fred MCP server now using a provided Kubernetes Helm template. Then we'll simply configure this in Claude and we're ready to go. I'll ask Claude to tell us about consumer confidence, federal fund rates, and housing starts and how it might impact our business next quarter. Or add an additional MCP server and build your own custom financial reports. With Sandbox MCP on Cosmonic Control, we can instantly get MCP servers into production with the confidence that we can run them securely. So use the links below to build MCP now and get started with one of our examples or use your own and know that whatever you build, you can instantly run it securely on any Kubernetes, on any cloud, or any edge using Cosmonic Control right now.